Where Lauren O'Neill was bitten today, the water was peaceful, while at the hospital, the news was positive. The 29-year-old out of intensive care.
She wishes to thank her heroic and very kind neighbours for the critical assistance they provided her.
And the St Vincent surgeons, the marathon operation to save her leg.
Her likely full recovery is testament to their extraordinary skills.
Lauren said it had just been a quick dip.
Usually we swim here, we thought it was safe. We didn't know the sharks can come over here.
But experts say now is the sharks' peak season.
I do think we need to be on alert for more shark bites. There should be more enclosures.
We do have to be vigilant in relation to this, but we don't have a program to net off Sydney Harbour.
At Redleaf Beach, swimmers back in the harbour, but inside the enclosure.
I've Googled so many beaches and I found this one. I thought this was the most safest option.
There should be more netting around certain beaches. Just to keep people safe.
Of the many popular harbour swimming spots, the majority do have netted enclosures accessible to the public, including Balmoral Beach, Parsley Bay, Clifton Gardens, Clontarf, and the newest swimming area, Maranawi Cove at Barangaroo.
The City of Sydney says it has long-term plans for more protected harbour swimming areas, like here at Elizabeth Bay, but they're on hold at the moment. The problem, not sharks, but water quality.
With pollution from sewers.
There's been a lot of buck passing. More needs to be done when it comes to improving our water quality in Sydney, and the state government needs to support that.
Paul Caddack, 7 News.